Alright, so hello, good evening everyone. Welcome to Yen. I'm Trish, and we're going to work with a little bit of therapeutic tremoring tonight. So in our body as mammals, we have a natural tremor mechanism. So if you look at an animal like a cat, like my cat Megatron, for example, sometimes they'll be relaxing, or when they feel something, they'll just give a little shake and shake it all off. All right. So as humans, we actually have that mechanism within our body. So sometimes, like when people are in shock, you'll see them shaking. But as humans, generally, we're conditioned to behave in a certain way. So when you see someone shaking, you normally try to tell them, just it's all right, calm down, calm down, calm down. So we actually suppress that tremor mechanism. So we're going to work with that a little bit tonight. So we're going to do a little bit of tremoring, and then we're going to melt into our shape. So listen to your body and just do what feels good. Sometimes for certain people, tremoring might feel very good and you might want to do it for a little bit longer, but we want to do a bit of regulation. So we want to tremor, then we want to rest and allow our body to integrate. Okay, so, and then during the tremoring as well, sometimes it could be, you might be able to see it quite visibly. Sometimes it can be quite subtle, just creating a vibration in the body to help to open everything up. Okay, so just as long as you feel it, there's no particular right or wrong. Okay, so let's start off this evening. Let's come into butterfly. Excuse me. All right, so we're just going to bring the soles of the feet together. Lengthen up, relax the shoulders, and maybe just feather the knees up and down a couple of times. Okay, and then we're just going to roll onto our back. So from here, roll down onto your back. And then just take a couple of breaths here, lengthen the spine, relax the shoulders. And just check in with the body, just notice how you feel. And just start to deepen the breath, so drawing the breath all the way into your hips, into your belly. Feeling that expansion of the belly like a balloon, and then from the belly starting to fill the full capacity of the lungs, bottom, middle, top, front side, back into the heart. Maybe breathing into the neck and throat. And then as you exhale, just gently softening the hips, softening up through the abdomen, softening through the chest and shoulders. Maybe you can relax your shoulders a little bit further down the side of the spine at the back. And the shoulders softening up through the neck and throat. Unclenching the jaw. Softening up through your cheeks, your face, your eyes. Through the eyebrow center. And just keeping the tip of the tongue resting on the roof of the mouth behind the two front teeth. And just taking a couple more nice, full, deep breaths here. Full yogic breaths, flooding the body from the hips all the way to the collarbones with the inhale. And as you exhale, just melting down. So if your hips are feeling a little bit tight tonight, you might feel there's a little bit of a shake already in the hips. So that's kind of what the tremor mechanism, except we want to be able to control it. Okay, so from here, we're going to just gently start to lift the pelvic floor, and then hug your belly into the spine, and very slowly, like you're moving underwater, we're going to start to bring the knees up very slowly. So what we're doing now is we're creating a range of motion, which is bringing the knees up and bringing them in towards each other, and then very slowly, like you're moving underwater, taking the knees back out apart. Okay, so this range of motion that we are working with, of taking the knees out slowly and bringing it back in, is called our bandwidth. Like a radio, we're tuning that bandwidth. And within that range of motion now, try to feel into your body and try to find where that point where you can feel that little tremor. Okay, so as you start to bring the legs, the knees closer up towards each other, you might start to feel that you can start to feel that little tremor. And it can be quite subtle, or it can be quite visible. And as long as you start to feel it, if you can't feel it, just continue with that gentle bringing in of the knees together and keeping the face relaxed, the shoulders are relaxed. And then once you've found that tremor mechanism, just start to breathe into it. And just starting to release. Just let everything be soft and heavy, and just let the body tremor by itself. And then sometimes it might tremor out. And then if at any time, if you feel the need to release, just slide the legs out in Shavasana. And then once you've found that tremor and breathing into it, maybe just starting to hum into it if you want to intensify it a little bit. then feeling and allowing it to move. So you're starting with the hips, and then maybe like right now I'm starting to feel it moving up through my lower back, and that's where it needs to go. And everyone's body's different and we feel different on different days. So just allowing, once again, if you need to rest at any time, just slide the legs out in Shavasana, take a break, let everything settle, and then come back into the position. And then any kind of gentle sounds that you might like to make. Sometimes if you're feeling a release, it might feel nice to do a little sigh and let everything out. And then perhaps you can start to move. If you're working with the humming breath, you can maybe start to use that breath, like the way we control the vibration of the sound within the body, and start to move it down. So if you're feeling, oh, okay, I need to bring it to my lower back, and bringing the sound there and feeling the tremor there, or maybe being able to bring it down the legs into the calves. And just keeping the breath flowing. Okay, let's take a couple more nice deep breaths here. And then when you're ready, just gently slide the legs out in Shavasana, maybe shake the legs out. And then just come into neutral for a minute. The spine is long, shoulders are relaxed, and keeping the tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth behind the two front teeth. Breathing into the body, observing the breath, observing the energy. But sometimes as we do a little tremoring, it starts to oxygenate the blood as well. And so if you're feeling any sensations, just breathing into them. As you exhale to softening. Okay. If you like, feel free to continue and stay in Shavasana. We're going to come back into that same position and just add a little bit more now. So if you feel that you're still feeling energy moving through the body, especially around your hips, your thighs, or any of the areas that we were shaking before, you can stay there. Otherwise, maybe just come into a little bit of gentle movement. And then when you're ready, bringing the knees back into your butterfly position. If you need to do any mobilizations as well, feel free to do so, okay? And then we're going to tune that bandwidth again. So we're going to start to gently bringing the knees up and then very slowly down to find that tremor. And then once you found that tremor, and start to breathe into it. And then from here, you can either just stay here and just stay with your hips on the ground for another minute or so. Otherwise, you can maybe start to gently lift the hips and keep a little bit of core engagement. So we're lifting the pelvis off the ground and with the tailbone slightly rolled under. And you might feel that you can get that little shake a little bit deeper into different areas of your body. Otherwise, just keep the hips on the ground. So that's just another option. Sometimes with gravity, we can help to get a little bit more blood flow from the hips up into the heart, especially if you've been sitting for long periods of time. Otherwise, if it feels more comfortable with the hips down, you can keep the hips down. And if you're feeling it moving, maybe just let the tremor move through the body. Keeping the face nice and relaxed. Okay, and then from here, let's gently slide the legs back out, come back into Shavasana. And just allowing everything to soften.
Keeping the breath deep and flowing, full yogic breaths from the hips all the way up into the collarbones. Exhale, just looking everything soft, melting down into the mat. Let's imagine that your mat is just rising up to hold you and meet you. Noticing the effects, absorbing the effects of that little tremoring that we did. Just breathing into it, allowing your body just to integrate. Okay. Ready, just slowly wiggle the fingers and toes, and then maybe just a little gentle stretch. And any kind of gentle mobilizations, it might feel nice to hug the knees into the chest now, and maybe rock from side to side as you rock from side to side, just lengthening your sit bones down towards the long end of the mat, creating a little bit more space with the lower back. Just gently circling your knees a few times, massaging out the back. Both knees in one direction and then gently back the other way. And then take the knees apart, circling them in opposite directions, keeping the hip crease nice and wide. And then gently back the other way. Okay. From here, putting the feet onto the ground and then come into a very gentle mobilizing twist, keeping the belly hugging in, shoulders relaxed on the mat, eye gaze wherever's comfortable, and just drawing the knees from one side to the other. All right, and then we're nice and even, come back to center, hug the knees back in and do a couple more circles. Okay, and then just relax the shoulders. From here, we're going to gently bring our feet. So from here, we're going to find our next bandwidth, and that bandwidth is going to be bringing your legs up and then very, very slowly, like you're moving underwater, bending the knees back in. All right, so I want you to try to find, your feet are roughly about hip width apart or whatever's a comfortable distance or even a bit wider. And then I want you to find that point where you can feel that tremoring in your legs, okay? So you don't need to keep the feet together. Sometimes whatever's comfortable for you. So if it's more comfortable with your feet together, otherwise you can bring the feet a little bit wider out, almost into like a happy baby sort of shape. So if you can't find the tremor, we just gently start to keep everything relaxed. So it's not like we're not actively pushing the legs out. We're just keeping everything soft and we're just gently bending the knees and then slowly taking the legs up. And then you should be able to feel where it's starting to tremor. And once you've found that tremoring, and once again, it can be quite subtle. Keep everything soft as well. So your knees are soft, the ankles are soft. And then just breathing into it. Okay, you can stay with the legs. Otherwise, maybe if you like, start to bring your arms up as well and start to take the arms up. And then I'm just finding that little shake, maybe bring the shoulders up. Bring the shake from the feet up into the hands and just let everything shake. Breathing into it, maybe a little yawn, a little sigh. So this is like making our own little chi machine. So if you've got the tremor in your legs, you can maybe just start to feel the tremor and bring it up into your arms and then I just want to shake the hands, shake the wrists, especially if you've been on devices all day or at screen. And so we're not actually doing it. So it's not voluntary. It's not like we're actually, you know, shaking it out. We are just finding that tremor, and then we're making it a little bit more intense if we want to. Okay, so. The hands, you can maybe just bring the hands up and down. So you can play with the bandwidth in the hands, otherwise just relax the hands and just find what works well for you at any time. If you need to, slide the legs out in Shavasana and take a break. Keep widening through the hips and then just feeling the hips in their sockets. So your knees could even be very bent, whatever's feeling good for you. And just keep deepening the breath. All right, when you're ready, slowly bend the knees and then slide the legs out. Give them a little shake out, maybe a little shimmy out through your body. And then coming back into Shavasana. So as we had the feet up, as you release, you might just feel a rush of oxygen, blood, energy in the body. If you're feeling any of that, it's normal. Just breathing into it and allowing everything to assimilate. Keeping the tip of the tongue resting on the roof of the mouth just behind the two front teeth. Deepening the breath. So just like sometimes the chi machine that you guys might be familiar with, as we do our tremoring, it's kind of like creating our own chi machine. Or at some gyms, there's a little thing that you can stand on, and after your workout, you stand on it, it vibrates. So it's similar to that, but we are doing it ourselves the old school way. Okay, let's take a couple more nice deep breaths here. And then when you're ready, just gently start to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, and then just stretch out. Maybe start to just gently point and flex the feet as you open up through the front of the legs, backs of the legs. If it's not comfortable with the arms above the head, keep the arms by your hips or by your shoulders. And so as you start to inhale, maybe starting to point the toes and just drawing that breath all the way down through the hips, your front of your legs, and through the knees, your shins, your tops of your feet, curling the toes down. And then as you exhale, maybe just gently flexing the feet and pushing out through your heels, pulling your toes back towards you, hug the belly into the spine, maybe a little arch. Stretching out. And then take a couple of breaths here. So we're just flowing the breath through all that area that we've been kind of jiggling and shaking and tremoring. And then when you're ready, let's hug the knees back in towards the chest. Maybe roll into a little ball. Shoulders away from the ears. And then gently roll the shoulders, neck and head back down. And then just massaging the spine. Draw a few circles with the hips and with the knees, sorry, in one direction. The other way. Check in with your body. Notice how everything feels. Circling the knees in opposite directions. Breathing into the hips. And gently back the other way. Okay. So from here, just going to stretch the legs out a little bit. So two options if you don't want to come into a forward fold. Sheila, feel free to grab your strap and you can hook your strap around your leg, okay, and come into this variation here. Or anyone who doesn't want to, who wants to stay on the mat, feel free just to do that, okay? And then you can maybe just use the tremoring as well, okay? Otherwise, another option is to come up and maybe just come into a forward fold like this. Okay, so, all right, we'll take this strap option, okay? just giving everyone different options. So so I give cues for different, depending on, so if, because Sheila can't, is not recommended to do forward folds like this, okay? So otherwise, if it's comfortable, so you can take your right leg out and then bring your left knee to the side, like a half butterfly, grab your blocks and stack your blocks in front of you, so like a little pillar if you like, okay, so that you can support your forehead and then you can progressively melt the blocks down. Okay, and we're just gonna hang out here for about a couple of minutes. So make sure that you're not at a point where anything feels like it's pulling or getting the shakes. Maintain a little bend in the knee. And then just gently melting down. So if you're seated, you can either have a flat back, otherwise maybe you can just round your back, and sometimes you get that nice opening across the back as well. And just breathing into that the back of that leg. If you've got your foot to the sky, then just maybe start to play around with the angles in the hip. Otherwise, if you're coming forwards, you're just maybe feeling that nice opening across the back at the same time. And breathing into wherever you're feeling the stretch. Once again, as in our yin practice, we never want to go to the point where anything feels like it's pulling or getting the shakes. If you're seated, then if you can hold your foot, maybe give yourself a nice little foot massage and just find the points on your foot that might feel a little bit sore. So right in the center of our foot, just underneath the, just in between the balls of the feet, that's your kidney point there. Might feel quite nice, but then again, we have reflexology points all across the feet that correspond with every single organ in the body. So maybe just going with your intuition and just giving yourself a nice little foot rub wherever it feels good. And for you guys on the mat, make sure you're not pulling too hard. So just relax your shoulders, relax your hands. If you are on your back, maybe you can slide that strap down towards your hamstring and maybe open up through the sole of the foot. So Diana and Catherine, stay where you are. I'm just going to demo. So for you guys, Sharon and Sheila, from this position here, you can maybe just slide it down or maybe take your hands and then just open up through the foot. So you're just starting to spread the toes and circling the foot in one direction, back the other way. Okay, and then for you guys who are seated, Diana and Catherine, just massaging, giving yourself a nice little foot massage in your seated position. And just keep breathing into whatever you're feeling, stretch. Maybe pointing your foot as well and flexing your foot. And it's a really nice, slow, gentle movements as if we're moving underwater. Keeping the body really nice and relaxed. And so just deepening the breath. Yeah. And so for Sheila and Diane, you're going to just now bend that knee in and then just circling the knee a few times in one direction, other way. And then you're going to just slide the leg out, shake it out. Okay. For Catherine and Diane, from in this position here, let's gently roll up through the spine, lengthening up through the spine, rolling, restacking shoulders away from the ears. Okay, take both legs out, give them a nice little shake out. So whether you're seated or you're lying down, shake the legs out. Okay, and then let's go on to the other side. So feel free, if you're lying down, if you want to take a moment in Shavasana, otherwise go on to your other side. So if you're on your back, you hook the strap across the arch of your foot. Otherwise, if you want a little bit more, you can bring onto the ball of your foot, but that's going to just make it a little bit stronger. So keep it on the arch of the foot. It's a little bit more relaxing. Okay, so make sure that you're not pulling at your, you're not at your full extension. Maybe keep the knee bent, stack the heel over the hip. And then for you guys who are seated, we're going to bring our blocks forwards. And then so you can option to come into a more active, like a, where you're coming with a flat back. Otherwise, maybe just round the back a little bit and you're feeling that nice opening across the back. And just breathing into it. Keep a little bit of engagement at the front of your body. And then just melting down. Once again, we don't want to get to the point where anything feels like it's pulling or getting the shakes. If you are, then just try to release it a little bit and just find that first point of resistance where you feel a little bit of tension, but it's still, you're feeling a nice opening, but it's still not pulling. You're not at the edge. And then just breathing into it and melting down here. Shoulders, softening the face. Okay, for you guys on your back, feel free now to slide the strap a little lower down towards your hamstring, or maybe just bring your hand onto the hamstring and then open the foot. Sheila and Sharon, tracing circles and almost like you're moving underwater, really nice, slow, gentle movements. And for Catherine and Diane, maybe bringing, if your hands are comfortable behind you, otherwise maybe holding onto the foot and giving yourself a nice little foot massage, whatever feels good. For you guys on your back, start to open up through all those little tiny bones in your feet, creating space. And also when we're seated as well, we can open up through all those little bones and maybe use our hands to give a little massage wherever it feels nice for you this evening. Take this up on the nice, deep, beautiful breaths here. Sorry, my cat's bell is really annoying. Sorry, guys. Okay, the joys of pet ownership. All right, from here, let's gently release. So Sheila and Diane, release and just circling that knee a few times, or the hip a few times, by circling the knee. And then Catherine and Diane, let's roll up through the spine, lengthening up. Exhale, relax the shoulders.
Okay. Release the blocks, extend the legs out, give the legs a nice little shake out in the hip sockets. Screen wipers with the feet. And from here, we're just going to do a very quick little rolling across the back. So we'll just focus, so find whatever is comfortable for you, but tonight I would suggest probably around the upper back, throw so somewhere underneath your shoulder, middle back, so around your shoulder blades, maybe up in between your shoulder blades. Okay, so, and then we'll come into our neck shape after that. So grab your tennis balls, and then from here, we're going to roll onto our back, keeping the knees bent. So we're not going to spend too long here. So we're going to spend maybe around 7 minutes or so. So we've got a bit of time to do everything else. So roll onto your back and then grab your tennis balls. If you want, grab your block as well. So if you're going to, so listen to your body, whatever feels good. If you're feeling tight in, so if you're doing this all day, if you're feeling tight up here, you might want to put the block of the balls higher up. Otherwise you can kind of roll them lower down. If you've got your blocks, your balls higher up, you might want to have your block close by so you can pop your block underneath your hips. Okay, so from here we come down and keeping the knees bent, you're more towards the bottom of your mat. And just bring the balls onto the shoulders, find a comfortable position, and then just melting down. Make sure that the balls are symmetrical so it will feel a lot nicer, and make sure that you're not actually rolling on the spine itself. Okay, so you can have the knees bent, have your feet slightly wider out, and let the knees roll in towards each other. So this might feel quite nice, and you're just gently swaying the knees from side to side. Otherwise, if you want a little bit more, maybe bring the knees and feet to hip width, and then push into your feet, lift the hips, and then slide your block underneath your sacrum, and then lower your hips, and then just create a little bit more pressure there. Okay, so just breathing into it. Softening down. So this should feel quite nice, like someone's giving you a massage. Soften the face, relax the shoulders. If you felt a little release, then maybe you can push into your feet, depending on how high the balls are, maybe rolling down a little bit into the next spot. Deepening the breath. Feels good. If your hips down on the floor, you can sway the knees to create a little bit of movement, or you can take the arms up. So I'm exaggerating the movement here, but you can kind of draw your shoulder up and down like this, and then that will help to get into it. If your ball is in between your shoulder blades, by doing this little movement here, but you can just give yourself a hug and do that like that. So then you don't have to keep your arm extended. Otherwise, just melting down. So just really listening to what your body needs right now. Maybe after all that, after the tremoring you did at the start, you might not want to be moving too much, and just melting down into it. Keep deepening the breath. Release and be rolling into the next spot. And then as the balls come further down your back, you might want to release the block a little bit, bring it to a lower end, or just bring the hips back onto the floor. And if you've
got your block, if you've got your block on your sacrum here also with your knees bent, another option is just to slide your legs all the way out. So make sure that the block's not on your lower back, but you're feeling just a nice little opening up through the hips and having the block on its lowest end. And I'm just extending the legs out, so we're just getting a nice little opening up through the hip flexors as well. Make sure there's no pinching in the lower back, so the block is on the little flat triangular bone just above your tailbone rather than on the actual lumbar spine. And it's softening down. Deepening the breath. Release for sure, just to maybe slide up a little bit more down. Otherwise, if you're enjoying where you're at, just melting there. And you can just adjust the block to move with you if you've got your legs extended. So I've just bent my knees and I've slid myself up a little bit to bring the balls down, and then I just slide the block a little bit higher up so it's still underneath my sacrum and not on my lower back. And then melting down to the next position or the next tight spot. Soften the face, soften the breath. As you start to release through the shoulders, maybe from your hips, you can start to widen out through the shoulders, maybe bringing the arms to your, in line with the shoulders, out to the sides if it's comfortable, or cactus arms, or maybe bringing the arms above the head if that feels good, just another option. Doing whatever feels good for your body. Be here for another couple of minutes. So just try to relax and enjoy it as much as you can. Just taking whatever option feels good. So once again, if sometimes just a little bit of very gentle somatic movement, sometimes it might feel nice just to melt down. Observing the breath, observing any sensation, especially this kind of referring sensation. Sometimes as we release a knot somewhere in the back, you might feel something else release, that your jaw might relax, or just observing those little subtle sensations within your own body. So yeah, it feels good. Feel free to slide up and adjust if you've got something release. Let's take a couple more nice deep breaths here. And when you're ready, if you're on a block, then you're just going to bend your knees, walk your feet back in, and then just lift the hips, remove the block. All right. Actually, let's get, while we're here with the tennis balls, let's bring these tennis balls down in towards our kidneys and our adrenals. So if you just slide them down a little bit more to the bottom of your ribs, on a little bit outside, away from the spine, and a little bit out, to just kind of feel where your ribs end, and then you feel in there, it should just feel a little bit tender, and you, your body will just kind of go, ooh, well, okay, and then melt down onto that spot. Okay, so our adrenal glands produce adrenaline in our body, which is that very good for our flight and fight response. So when we are in an emergency situation where you need to lift a car off a baby or something, then that's great, but we don't want our body to be overrun with adrenaline. And a lot of the times in our very busy world, with lots of things that are happening and constant deadlines, sometimes we have an overabundance of adrenaline in the body. So we want to just give a nice little bit of acupressure onto those points. And then as we do, creating that pressure, it's kind of like when you squeeze a garden hose, you stop the flow of water, but then when you release it, all this fresh water can flow through. So it's the same concept here. So we're just putting a little bit of squeezing on it. And then if it feels quite tender, just feel free to stay there. Otherwise, if you want a little bit more, you can maybe start to just gently draw the knees up, and that's just going to add a little bit more weight onto it. And then whatever feels good, hanging out in stillness, or maybe just some gentle movements here, just massaging it out. Just keep softening the face, softening the shoulders, softening the jaw, all the areas through your forehead, through the eyes, all the areas that we tend to hold tension. Maybe a little sigh. Just release all that excess adrenaline that we don't need. This life is meant to be full of ease. Keeping the breath flowing, just once again, observing any kind of sensations. If you do that, you might feel softening and release through other parts of the body. Take a couple more nice deep breaths here. Release as much as you can for these last few breaths. And then when you're ready, just if you've got your knees, release the knees, release the ball, slide the legs out, and just maybe give a little shimmy out, and come back into Shavasana. Lengthening the spine, relaxing the shoulders, sliding the shoulders down into their sockets, down the sides of the spine. It's long, and tip the tongue on the roof of the mat behind the two front teeth. Breathing into the body and just observing any subtle changes and breathing into them. And ready, just gently bring some movement back in. We're doing fingers and toes. We're circling with some ankles. Just do whatever feels good. Might feel nice to stretch out first. Maybe a little yawn, and then when you're ready, hug the knees back in. Round into the ball, rock from side to side. Just massaging back. Massaging those adrenals that we've been rolling on. And then just circling your knees a few times in one direction. And gently back the other way. Okay. From here, let's just come onto our side in a nice fetal position. And slowly support yourself up. Let's come into just a little couple of cat-cows, a little bit of mobilization, and then we're going to come into thread the needle. Okay, so coming up into tabletop and then lengthening the spine. And as you exhale, just rounding the spine. If you like, maybe just staying here for a breath or two. So you can either move with the breath if that feels good for you, arching and curling a few times. Otherwise, maybe as you exhale, you round. And then as you inhale, breathe into the back of the body. And as you exhale, keep lifting the belly, lifting the chest and widening out across the back. Keeping the front of the neck active, rolling the chin into the throat. And then starting to widen the hips and the collarbones, hugging the belly in and then lengthening the spine as you to arch. And then you can either continue just doing cat-cows with the breath, or you can stay in your arch position, keeping the belly hugging into the spine, tops of the thighs rolling in towards each other. And then as you inhale, you breathe into the heart. As you exhale, you squeeze the backs of your shoulder blades. Keeping the tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth behind the two front teeth. As we squeeze and contract those between the shoulder blades, maybe getting a little bit more opening through the chest. And then as we squeeze and contract, we're drawing more blood into that area as well. So let's, and then once you've done a few breaths, if you've been holding, then exhale and round. As you round, maybe feeling a little bit more release and opening up through the upper back, through the that space that we've been rolling and squeezing. From here, so move with the breath, or just come into a little bit of disco cat, so free form movement, and then maybe making a few little figure eights through the shoulders, feeling neck and throat, and opening, closing the mouth, releasing the jaw. Okay. Gently draw yourself back into a neutral position. And then from here, take your right hand or whichever is your back hand, reach up, inhale. As you exhale, push your knees back into the floor, slide that hand underneath, just underneath the wrist, so we're not too close in towards the knees. Bring your shoulder down into the midline of your body and then come onto the side of the head, side of your shoulder. Push back into your knees so your hips aren't rolling to one side, keeping the hips anchored over the knees. Inhale, and then as you exhale, if it feels good, you can just maybe bring your left hand by your face and maybe just gently start to roll that top shoulder back. So you're just feeling a nice little stretch out across the shoulder blades. Keep lifting that top shoulder up towards the sky as you widen your collarbones. Just breathing into the back. Keep the belly hugging into the spine. And so we're just getting a nice little stretch for all that rolling that we've done. So once again, we want to feel a nice stretch, but we don't want to feel, so you might want to go to the edge and then release a little bit, or just come to that point that we're feeling a nice stretch, but not to the full range. And then you can stay here, because as we start to roll that top shoulder back, we'll feel that through the shoulders, the upper back. And then otherwise, maybe you can take your left hand and walk it up beyond your head. And so you're just coming in, bringing that hand above the head, and you're feeling that stretch across the back. Okay, sorry, Sharon, you could just do the other side, yeah. And so from here, just keep the knees pushing in, hug the belly in, and stay here. Just keep breathing into it. So you can just continue with the little twisting action to get into the back a little bit more. Otherwise, if it feels good, maybe you can even just wind that bottom hand, palm facing down. So from the top of your arm, you start to wind it down. And that way you're feeling that stretch coming all the way down through the arm. And then if you like, you can either continue with the twist to get into the back. Otherwise, you can get into the front of the body and let the chest kind of melt back down a little bit. And so you're just feeling that little squeeze through your lung point in the corner of that underneath, of the corner of your chest on the underneath side. Just keeping the belly hugging in. Once again, just find a position that feels quite good that you can kind of just relax into. All right, when you're ready, bring your left hand back next to your face. We're going to open up through Wild Things. So we're just going to inhale, open that arm up, swivel on your left knees, take your other right leg and bring it behind you, and then just stretch it out here. So just keep that bottom shoulder wrapping underneath and then lifting the hips, just opening up. And just breathing, especially if you felt that we're compressing the lung point, and just opening up through the front of the body here. Okay. Exhale, come back into tabletop. And then just doing a little bit of freeform movement here. Keep the breath flowing. Just checking with the body. Notice how you feel. One side compared to the other. Maybe a few cat-cows. And then we'll go on to the second side when you're ready. Okay, so let's gently come back into neutral. And then lengthening the spine, I'm going to take the left hand, inhale, open it up to the sky. So you're just reaching up first and feeling that opening up through the chest. As you exhale, hug the belly in towards the spine. Push your knees back into the floor. Slide that hand just underneath the wrist, so not too close in. And then come onto the side of the shoulder, side of the head. Keep your spine nice and tall. So push back into the knees and then lengthen the spine as you exhale. Maybe just bring that right hand next to your face and then gently start to roll that top shoulder back. So first we're just getting into the shoulder, getting that nice stretch across the shoulder blades, widening through the collarbone, so you're lifting up through that top shoulder, so we're not kind of collapsing down, keeping the belly hugging in towards the spine. Breathing into wherever you're feeling it. Yeah, you can keep that hand there, or otherwise maybe start to walk that right hand out beyond your head. It feels good. Maybe starting to wind. Bring that hand back in and wind that bottom hand so your palms facing down. So these are all just options. Find what works it feels good in your body this evening. And then from here, you can stay here with that open twist. Otherwise, maybe starting to gently melt the chest back down so we're feeling that nice little squeeze through the lung points. And sort of almost coming into a half heart melting pose. So you're just starting to melt the belly towards the thighs. I'm just allowing the chest to melt back down. So we're just feeling that little squeeze through the lung points on the bottom side, and then keep winding that arm downwards. And breathing into the stretch. Take a couple more nice deep breaths here. And then when you're ready, bring your right hand back next to your face. So you inhale, start to unroll yourself. Swivel on your right knee, straighten that left leg, bring it back behind. And take that left hand to the sky and then open it up here. Stretching out. Lifting out of the hips, lifting out of that bottom shoulder. And then when you're ready, exhale, come back down into tabletop. And then come back into your freeform movement. Checking in with the body, notice how everything feels. Okay. From here, let's just gently come into child's pose for a moment. Draw the hips back towards the heels and just have a nice little stretch out, soothing with a little mobilization and just a count and stretch. So roll your, tuck your tailbone under, your pelvis under, and then stretching hands out, drawing the bum back towards the heels, maybe just a gentle little sway from side to side. Widening the shoulders. All right. When you're ready, let's roll back up. Let's come into tadpole pose now with the option to add a little bit more tremoring. So let's grab our bolster. And so couple of options here. So I'm just going to give you guys a few different options. You can try them out and see what feels best for you. So come up onto your bolster, and then from here you can either have your leg, your knees a little bit forwards, more in a child's pose variation, or I like to bring my knees in line with my hips because this is going to feel quite nice on my hips, and then roll yourself forward. So options, sometimes you can do this pose with your head turned to the side. Otherwise, maybe bring yourself a little forward so that you can rest your chin on the bolster, and you can maybe just bring a block to support your forehead. So that way your neck is straight. Okay. Otherwise, if you like, you can maybe bring a block on its lower end, grab a tennis ball and put that tennis ball on your block and just give yourself a little massage through your forehead right now. Okay. So, and just your hands can, if you're using a tennis ball, you can hold the tennis ball just to. And so from here, just you can just feel that, let the gravity melt, and you can just massage the forehead or above your eyebrows or the eyebrow center, wherever it feels good, wherever you might hold tension, and you might even want to turn your head to the side and get into the temple here. Okay, and at the same time, just kind of relax everything and let everything be heavy. Down. If you don't have a tennis ball and you're just massaging your, you can massage your forehead on the block, and you just use the end of the block and just gently turning your head from side to side if you don't want as much pressure. Just really listening to your body. And then try to relax everything, allow everything to melt down. Mm. And that might just feel quite nice already. If you want to add a little bit more, you can incorporate, you can start to play with a range of motion. So it's very subtle, and it's a tilt of the pelvis, like I'm tucking my tailbone under and then I'm arching. You might not even be able to see, so stay where you are. But the movement is basically this tuck of the pelvis and a gentle arch, right? But it's so subtle, and you might be able to find a little tremor there just to release from the, through the back, okay? So it's this tilt the pelvis under, arch. But I'm very, very much exaggerating the movement right now, because when I was doing on my bolster, you couldn't even see it, right? So if you like, you can start to incorporate this movement here, okay? And by doing that, you might be able to find a little tremor, so either in the hips or in your lower back, and then you can tap into that tremor and then allow that tremor to move through the back just to shake everything up a little bit. Okay, so that's just an additional option. Otherwise, just melting down where you are and massaging your head and just melting. Okay, otherwise you can do a little bit of tremoring and just shake everything out, or don't worry about the forehead. And so lots of different options, and I am recording this, so you can always take one option that feels really nice for you right now and come back another day and do the session again and try a different option for your body.
And if you're working with a trimmer, maybe bring that trim up your shoulders or your hips, or just whatever feels good.
You've been rolling on your temple on one side, just swap it over so you're nice and even. If you have been tremoring, maybe just take a break just to regulate and just back into stillness.
Staying in your pose, keeping the eyes closed and keeping the head straight now. From here, with the eyes closed, just another option if you like, very slowly just turn and draw your eyes to one side with the eyelids closed, and then gently bring them across to the other side. So it's stay with your head straight and your eyes closed, but you're just gently looking to one side and then gently, very slowly bringing the eyes to the other side. So just, and that is your range of motion. And then maybe you can start to feel your eyes starting to very gently tremor, and just releasing and softening and shaking out through the eyeballs. So our eyes are open all day, taking in all this external stimuli. You might feel a little release and just feel that release maybe melting down your face. Once again, these are all just options. You can just continue melting where you're at if it feels good. Becoming the eyes, you might be able to feel the eyes just lightly flickering and softening the face as you feel that tremor. You might feel that energy just moving down through the face. Maybe a little yawn, maybe a little sigh, let it all go. Alright, and then just gently stopping the tremor. If you've been tremoring, you can come back into stillness. Very, very slowly, start to keep your eyes closed, your eye gaze soft, keep the body relaxed, just gently lift your head. And then just straight one leg, slide off your bolster onto your back, slide the bolster out of the way, and then make your way into a Shavasana. And just coming into our final Shavasana. Sending the legs out, lengthening the spine, widening the shoulders, and sliding the shoulders back down away from the ears. Back of the neck is long. Tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth behind the two front teeth. Keeping the body nice and relaxed, and just keeping that breath deep and flowing. Eyes just heavy in their sockets. Okay, so if you are watching this as a video replay,
And I encourage you to stay in Shavasana for as long as you like, maybe another 10 or 15 minutes, especially after tremoring and melty shapes. I'm just gently going to get up and say goodbye. So thank you. Namaste.